They say we listen to a military band with our eyes. How it looks, to a great extent, is how it sounds. The 2nd Military District Band has been sounding good for over 100 years. Today, their uniform is a colourful anachronism. In 1874, the bright coloured jackets and white helmets were standard dress. But even then, they must have caught the eye.
What does the uniform do to you?
Makes you feel very, very good. It's almost a sense of, you know, euphoric. It does a lot for me, actually. It makes the adrenaline flow sometimes. It's not like dressing up or anything like that, but it gives a sense of belonging, a sense of sort of, how do you say? Pride.
Van Panna! Ta! Van Standat! Peace! Rest! Don't talk. Don't move. Right. There's a few people here with helmets all up on crooked, and there's a bit of brass not being cleaned.
The white helmet shall dazzle. The brass button shall twinkle. The trouser shall have a crease as sharp as a knife.
Lift your heads high, you're in the army.
And if the 46 musicians in uniform do become a little slack, the band sergeant major will draw attention to the fact, in the way band sergeant majors have always done.
Got it? Let's see a good one. Band of Tanner! Ta!
Their home is Victoria Barracks in Sydney, the cradle of Australia's military tradition. The men of the 2nd Military District Band, or 2MD as they are known, spend a lot of time making sure they maintain that tradition. 2MD is Australia's oldest military band, and quite possibly its best. It is definitely the versatile one.
I've been alive forever, and I wrote the very first song. I put the words and the melodies together. I am music and I write the songs. I write the songs that makes the whole world sing. I write the songs of love and special things. I write the songs that makes the young girls cry. I write the songs. My home lies deep within you, and I've got my own room in your soul.
Their average age is 29. The age range, 17 to 53.
Even though I'm very old, I write the songs that makes the whole world sing.
Many of them have come up through the Army's College of Music. But somewhere amongst the older ones are a professional jazz musician, a couple of ex-school teachers, an accountant, a baker, a plasterer, and a bus driver.
Oh, my music makes you dance, gives your spirit to take a chance. And I wrote some rock and roll so you'd feel secure. My music's in your heart, and it's a real fine place to start. It's from me, it's through you, it's from you, it's from me, it's worldwide.
The men of 2MD have been welded into a team, and the ex-school teachers, plasterer and bus driver spend a lot of time brushing up that teamwork.
Come on, Jenner!
But the band is just one tiny segment of that vast team, the Australian Army. Although personal exuberance may be just there beneath the surface, and formality does break down from time to time, the band members are always and finally subject to that army discipline.
I write the songs, I write the songs.
The musicians of 2MD are part of a system that they can't escape. They are in the army. Like it or not, though they are musicians, they are soldiers too.
Are you guys soldiers or not? I've seen a lot and I can't work out for myself. Are you a soldier, Lindsay?
Well, their priority job is number one, to be a soldier or program work, so yes, we know.
So you don't think of yourself as a musician first?
No, no, you're supposed to be a soldier first, so soldier first, then a musician.
What about any of the rest of you? What's your thoughts about that? Doug?
Well, the very fact that we are members of a band corps, in that category, I don't think we could be placed strictly as soldiers.
Do you feel like a soldier?
I certainly don't.
We're supposed to think like musicians and act like soldiers.
If we Australia were at war, what role would you play?
First busters at Bondi Station.
Yeah. Are we going to the task force?
The scripture bearers are riflemen. You have your own choice. Oh, well, as far as I know, you have a choice of what you want to do. But as in Vietnam, most musicians were stretcher bearers in those days. But I wouldn't really know what happens today. I suppose I don't think anyone really knows.
Does rank overrule musicianship in a band like this?
Well, yes, it does, because it's supposed to. Because your best musician is not your best NCO.
You find it works, do you? Being a soldier, yeah. And being a musician.
Yeah.
Well, you have to.
It's been working for, well, how long? 100 years,
well,
at least.
Probably a band, the first band, so
they're still going.
Occasionally, amongst the endless parades, marches and concerts, something breaks the routine. This time it's to be a country tour, a week in the bush.
We sit and talk and watch a hawk making lazy circles in the sky. We know we belong to the land, and the land we belong to is grand.
They have to rehearse even more, and during the tour itself they will play even more still. The band is being let loose for a six-day tour of country New South Wales, a week away from parade ground discipline. For the younger members, and that means most of the band, this will be a first.
Oklahoma every night, my honey lamb and I,
Oklahoma,
and the waving wheat.
What is that? What is the problem there?
Okay. The soldier musicians are going to play a lot of music and paint a few towns red.
Oklahoma in the night, come sweeping down the plain.
Oklahoma.
And the waving wheat, the chalk smells sweet, and the wind comes right behind the rain. Oklahoma every night, my honey lamb and I.
Oklahoma. We sit and talk and watch our heart making lazy circles in the sky. We know we belong to the land, and the land we belong to is grand. And when we say, yow, ah, yippee, yippee, yay, you know we're saying, God, you and fine Oklahoma.
By the end of the tour, they will have given 17 performances in 7 country towns in just 6 days. And military bands don't have road crews. They do it all themselves, and overtime is a word that hasn't yet worked its way into the military dictionary. Two MD is just the sort of band that would make a union organiser grit his teeth. In between acts, the bus becomes not only transport, but bedroom, library, and gambling den. But none of them for very long.
By the centre, quick, march!
If some of the young warriors do what young warriors normally do on their afternoons off, others don't. The musician in them doesn't allow them to pass up the chance of a practice. One thing a military band provides is almost unlimited time for practice. But one thing a military band doesn't provide is an outlet for private ambitions. a fortnightly paycheck, and military rank aren't enough for some with dreams of stardom.
Eventually, through my trumpet playing, I want to become one of the best. I admire certain trumpet players that I'd like to be as good as, and through the aid of the army, the hours I spend there, I hope to achieve that.
Blokes that have been through the army, in our case in the band, have gone on to club work, recording with big names, this type of thing. I guess the spot is there if you want to take it.
Does being in a public service band prevent you from becoming excellent? And you're a 9-to-5 musician, aren't you now?
Well, I think if you apply yourself, if you really want to do something, you'll make yourself better all the time. The jobs that we have to do and the things that are required of us, like for instance, we've made records and the band's come up to a very high standard to make the records. And then when we've made the record, that's all forgotten. We don't do that ever again.
So far as the general public is concerned, though, it's a man in uniform, it's a lance corporal or a corporal so-and-so coming forward. It's not really the same as being a pop star, is it?
I think the public look at us as a group. They don't look at us as individuals, no, because we're in uniform. Just like when you see a heap of soldiers on parade, you can't pick out any individual because everyone looks the same, don't they?
But is anyone here a soloist or an individual in this group?
Well, I am myself, and there's Craig down the bottom, he's a solo in his own right.
Do you feel that you are a soloist or that you are just a member of the band?
Oh, well, yes, Ron, I'm a soloist, but I think more than anything else, I'm a part of the band. I sort of see myself more as a member of the band. I take pride in that. More than anything else, I think, sure, I do a bit of singing, but more than anything else, I pride myself on being a bloke in the band.
Is it a kind of dream? Floating out on the tide, following the river of death downstream, or is it a dream? There's a fog along the horizon, a strange glow in the sky, and nobody seems to know. Suddenly burns so pale, bright eyes.
How long has this band been on tour?
We started, we left Sydney on Monday afternoon. So that's a few days now. Gone right around through Cowra, Parks, Forbes and Wellington. Oh, we're going to Wellington. And Dubbo is our sort of main stopover. Spending 2 days here.
What made you want to join the army?
Well, I always liked the idea of joining the army. And when I found out you could be a musician, I thought I was sort of getting the best of both worlds, so to speak.
The tour is about to wind up. The army should be pleased. Their showpiece band has been a hit. The 46 musicians would have their own reactions to the experience, as individual as their own temperaments. They've been working and living closely together for almost a week. Plenty of time to grate on each other's nerves. It has, in fact, been a reasonably harmonious time. But would they like to keep it up? The question is academic. Tomorrow, the members of 2MD, the quiet ones, the ragers, the drinkers and the teetotalers, the churchgoers and the racegoers, will get on that bus together and go home.
Do you fellas in the band ever have any fights?
Disagreements.
Fights.
Disagreements, very rarely. Surprisingly, because there's so many blokes, it's very rarely that there is a fight.
Is a fight illegal?
Yes, it is.
But it goes behind the arm.
Depending on who sees it.
Yeah, true.
It's normally, if you're going to have a fight with somebody, it's normally, if it's not instantaneous, it'll happen, it'll be arranged out the back somewhere,
And
out of the boss's way or something. And as long as it doesn't affect your job, you know, you can do it. But rarely, very rarely happens.
In other words, you all get along pretty well in the band?
Yeah, basically. We all argue and bitch a lot, but we basically be pretty good friends, I think.
We all enjoy our work. We enjoy the music we play, well, the majority of it. There's obviously a couple of things that we don't like. But,
like Colonel Bogey.
But overall, I think we got on really well.
Yeah, it's funny that, you know, like a lot of guys have got different temperaments and all that sort of thing in the band, personality clashes and all that sort of thing, but as soon as you start playing a piece of music, the personalities come together and you've got to work as a team and it all happens at the same time. You know, it's terrific. It gives you a great feeling.
We'll be right back. the 2nd Military District Band could be the best soldiers in the land. They win their battles without a shot being fired, perform for all ages wherever required. What they play varies an awful lot. Sometimes they like it, and sometimes they do not.